Okay, ladies and gentlemen, good evening or good whatever, whenever you're watching it. This is going to be my very first video vlog on my blog, basically. It's going to be talking about basically what I've been writing on the blog and getting video format. Yeah, a couple of people have been telling me, yes, we can't see what they've been writing, and that's why we've not been able to join the conversation. People don't really love reading anymore. Would have preferred it if it was in a video fashion. So for those of you lazy people that can't read, this one's for you out here. Don't say I didn't do anything good for you guys. This is basically the very first article published on the blog. It's Nigeria Failed State. I'm going to go through the whole article. I have the article right here on my system, and that's what I'm going to read through and explain some points. And basically that's what we're going to be doing now. First of all, before we start, I have to first of all apologize. The camera work is a bit shoddy because I'm the only one doing it, and my partner is a bit busy now, and I hope maybe before the next video it will be available for us to work together on the work. And secondly, I have to apologize for the stash. I've been very busy at work and I've not been able to get a clean shave, and maybe I'll give you guys 1 second to like make the mustache look. If your one was funny, just drop a comment on drop a comment down in the comment section. But let's get down to the main business. It's Nigeria Failed State. Now let's read the first paragraph in the blog, and then I'm basically going to be reading every chapter I read. I just try to explain something. So I'll go through sentences where I need to expand it more, and then you know how it basically goes when you do this kind of thing. Okay. Okay, first of all, Nigeria, during the process of gaining independence from the English colony, was still as the great African superpower, the emerging world power from the sub-Saharan. This was largely due to its population. Yes, Nigeria's population during that period was around 35 million. I didn't really put it down on the blog, but I mean, all of us knew that. And now, 35 million now looks like a small number, but now that we're approximately around 160 million, but during that period, it was a huge number. I mean, Nigeria had a bigger population than England, Germany, France. Nigeria was one of the most populated lands in the whole world during that period, and it really bode well for the country, because I mean we all know the impact of having high population. That means a bigger market for them within the country. And then obviously the second thing that was incredible about Nigeria was its land mass. Not just land mass, because I mean, we're talking about desert land, we're talking about arable land, land that could produce things. People don't know this, but Nigeria used to be known for making rubber, cocoa and coal. And this was Nigeria's big investment plan. And let me not get ahead of myself. Then the discovery of oil during the independence talk process seemed to just be an icing on the cake. That's it. It wasn't like that was, a lot of people don't know this, but oil was not Nigeria's the thing that made people think Nigeria would be an economic superpower. It was actually its population, its arable land. Oil was something discovered later that said, wow, this country is going to be like pretty incredible. So basically Nigeria was poised to be the its country, that's like the African superpower. Basically, let's go down to the blog and read down further. It was clearly evident that Nigeria had the natural resources to become not only an economic superpower, but also a military superpower that can take an active role in policy making, not only in Africa but in the world. Because of its population, yes, we could afford to have a huge military. We could afford to keep a huge military, and with the economic, the perceived economic stability of the country, we could be able to afford to keep the huge military. Not only about being able to have the human resources to. A huge military. Another important thing to keep in a huge military is the financial resources. I mean, take a look at Indonesia. Indonesia maybe China. China would be a perfect example. China have much more population, have much more human resources to have a bigger military than the US. But obviously, we know when it comes to military, US, the United States is the biggest military. And that's because we not only have the human resources to be able to keep that, but they have also the financial resources, because this war gear doesn't come cheap. I mean, production of this war gear, the amount of money that goes into it, this is a lot of things. But Nigeria was seen as a country that could be able to not only afford it financially, but keep human resources. We maybe talk about how whether Nigeria has been able to succeed or fail in that field, but it was basically poised to be able to help in becoming a world player, not just an African player, definitely an African player, maybe Asian bowler. We're expecting Nigeria to be part of the world game. Like, has Nigeria lived up to that expectation? Maybe when we read further, we'll find out. And then after so many years of independence, Nigeria is still highly underdeveloped, has an unstable democracy. I think the development process for everybody watching this video who is in Nigeria doesn't need explanation. For anybody that who is not in Nigeria just needs to go anywhere in Nigeria and see the horrible places. I'm not talking about googling Abuja or some of these very highly developed areas. I'm talking about not just only Abuja, some exceptions of Abuja are not well developed, the roads are bad, but I mean, we'll get down to it. Then obviously we know Nigeria is an unstable democracy. Nigeria spent a lot of its years, I can't remember the amount of years, I think I'll put it down in the comment section, the amount of years Nigeria has been through the military dictatorship, and yet, although Nigeria was founded as a democracy, it has spent most of its time as a recent under military dictatorship, and even now that Nigeria is practicing democracy, I mean, we all know that it's not an ideal democracy. I mean, most countries still regard Nigeria as an authoritarian country, and we go a bit into it in this blog, but later on, as new posts come, we'll maybe delve into that later. Then that big problem Nigeria had, and we said it in the blog here, the country has a problem with systemic corruption. When I mean corruption that dredges into the whole bone, I mean the whole spine of the Nigerian government is full of corruption, and everybody knows that it's not a secret. Even if it's a secret, it's basically the world's worst kept secret. Now, Nigerians and indeed the whole world are disappointed. Yes, they should be, and that's what basically we're talking about here. Is this what the heroes who campaigned for the country's independence envisioned for them? After asking myself these questions, this informed short title of this essay is Nigeria a failed state? It is why? Who is to blame? Is there hope? Okay, that was the first chapter. You know, I explained it as I was going through it, so I don't think I need to run down it again. So let's go down to the second chapter then. The second paragraph, please. Sorry, very sorry about that. I'm not going to unedit this out. Trust me, this is going to be unedited. This is like the worst video I'm trying to do. These are going to be run and gone videos for like the very first few periods, but I mean, as we go on, as we get better, as we get bigger, as we branch off, hope gets better. To give a simple answer here now, let's go to the second chapter. To simply answer my question here, not yet. Then I put in bracket, you can close your browser and go back to other phone site. Thanks for reading. That was my lame attempt to crack a joke, and sorry for that. I won't try that kind of lame attempt again. Okay, let's look at the scenarios one after the other. Yes, Nigeria is the biggest economy in Africa and 24th in the world, according to reports released by the International Monetary Fund as of October 2015. But according to the World Bank, Nigeria's Gini ratio was 48.83. Which was last measured in 2010, and it was 48.8 when it was measured by the UNDP in 2013. So maybe obviously the Gini ratio would have changed by now. The reason why it didn't change from 2010 to 2013 was Nigeria basically had a stable economy during that period, but I suspect that there have not been anybody to check it. Maybe I implored the IMF or the UNDP to publish another report and tell us what's going on now. But due to this recession, I expect that the Gini ratio will be way higher than it is right now, but there's no data backing that up. And one thing you can realize about this, we try to, everything we see, we try to be sure of it and put facts, give you guys facts, data, hard data for you guys to go through it. We don't try to tell you to believe your words, believe our words for it here. Okay. Then we'll try to explain Gini ratio as made by Ronaldo. Gini is statistical depression intended to represent the ranges from 0 to 100 and the inequality ratio of the country. I'm reading this blog very fast. I expect you to have read the blog by now. If you have not, you could go to the website, to the blog and read it. It's going to be down at the comments in the description section for you to read. It's Eddie's views. It says these politicalviews.blogspot.com.ng. I know it's very long and very boring. I would like a new name. So if you think there's a better name for the blog, you could put it down in the comment section again. But let's go back to the work. So, with a country that has that kind of GDP, me, 24th in the world and the biggest in Africa, you're expecting marvel. It is incredible. So, but why does Nigeria have this kind of huge Gini ratio? Let's compare it with countries. I tried to do something in this blog. I mean, a lot of people asked me this question before. Why didn't I compare Nigeria with like countries like the US, Canada, England? These countries have been stable and I've been working for a long time. So comparing them with Nigeria would be unfair to Nigeria on its own. But we try to compare it with Nigeria's rising peers. So we try to talk about here, we try to compare Nigeria with Brazil, which we found, South Africa first, we found out that the Gini ratio, according to the World Bank, they measured in 2011, South Africa had a Gini ratio of 63.4, and Brazil had a Gini ratio, also measured by the World Bank at the same year, of 52.9. Now, looking at these two countries, you realize, wow, Nigeria is doing way better than these countries, and they're basically Nigeria's peers. So why are we complaining about Nigeria? But you realize something. Brazil is also a very corrupt country. People don't really know that. They think Brazil is very corrupt. I mean, Petrobras scandal is still going on. They keep impeaching presidents. They keep trying to impeach the president to ensure that this could keep going on. I don't want to get into that. It's not part of the blog, but Brazil has a huge problem in corruption. Then Jacob